We do not want to be the footnote, however interesting that footnote might be, in a Western canonical story. We want to own and present the histories from this part of the world as central. We always say that M+ is far more than just a building. It's many things to many people. When we build a big museum like this into a city like Hong Kong, we are adding to the ecology, the cultural ecology of the city, while at the same time thinking very carefully about what we need to bring to the international world. So how we bridge East and West is a critical part of that conversation. We want to make sure that our histories, our architecture, design, moving image, film, art histories make very significant contributions, and that the focus of that historical work primarily sits with the stories in the region. The story of contemporary Chinese art, when we look at it from the four decades of the 70s through to the teens, is an extraordinary story. It's very rare in the art world that you see something very unique and new emerge. And the fact that M+ Plus's founding collection was the gift made by Dr. Uli Sig of his collections of contemporary Chinese art is a profoundly important one, because it sets us aside from any other institution in the world. Wang Du's work is a surprising entry into the Sig collection, because he's of course a diasporic artist. And the interesting segue into Sig collection is its relationship to media culture. Including it as part of the Sig collection gifts is immediately starting to think about those relationships between a collection that is looking at a national identity and at the same time recognizing that being a Chinese artist may require you also not to be in the mainland or in Greater China, that there is absolute purpose in making art outside a city or a nation, but that also comments on the creative energy comes out of situation that perhaps has nothing to do with China at all, which is the case with the Wang Du work. Lin Tian Mao braiding, wonderful work by Chinese female artist. This is actually a self-portrait, it's a digital print, and then you look behind, which is where the sense of the work comes together, the braiding, the plait, the threads that move together to create this beautiful, beautiful line, and you come to a small moving image screen which shows the hands at work, the making that takes place, the really important work of being artist is reflected in this work. We're standing in front of one of the most important works in the collection by Hong Kong artist Liu Xiaokuang. He was a leading light in the New Ink movement and established abstraction in a form that had a deep literati historical tradition. But what we see here is an abstraction that's drawn out of Eastern philosophical thinking. Already you can see the use of the ink to make this beautiful, dense void in the middle with a shaft of light coming through the top. Secret. No secrets. Right now we are here at Asian Field. What is extraordinary is how the general public immediately respond to it and understand it almost instinctively, a very personal experience that is also a very universal one. What you also see is a huge variety and uniqueness of every single clay figure. And that diversity is also inside every single human being. In our uniqueness, we are also together as a species. And that relationship, that dynamic between being together, being human together, but also being very different together, means something profound in our world today. Thank you.